Hello everyone, welcome. So today we will discuss class 7, second chapter of geography, Inside Our Earth. So in this, we all know that we stay on the earth, right? The outer surface of the earth. So now we need to study what is there in the interior of the earth. And why do we need to study that? Because we need to know how various rocks are being formed, what are the different types of rocks, everything. Okay, so before we go into that, we need to find what is there inside our earth. So for that, we need to see how is the earth divided. Now earth, the outermost layer of the earth is known as crust, the one on which we stand, that is the crust. Fine. So that is basically the land, and that is known as the lithosphere. That is land, it is stone, that is why it is a lithosphere. The middle portion is the mantle, which is basically in a molten format. So mantle is in a molten mass. Okay, so a core mantle boundary is there, and then after that we have the outer core. There's an outer core, and inside that we have an inner core. So in the innermost, it is the core which is present. And like we saw that there are different layers that we have on the earth. The uppermost layer over the earth's surface is called the crust. It is the thinnest of all the layers. It is about 35 kilometer on continental masses and about 5 kilometer on the ocean floor. The main mineral constituents of the continental mass is Cl, and Cl is silica, Si for silica and Al for aluminium, Cl. And the oceanic crust mainly consists of silica and magnesium. So this is in the Cl, is where Cl is basically in the continental mass, but when we talk about ocean, it is silica and magnesium. So silica and magnesium, so SiMa, silica and magnesium, Si and Ma, so it is known as Cma. So Cl is the continental region and Cma is in the oceanic crust which is there. Now just beneath the crust is a mantle which extends up to a depth of 2900 kilometer below the crust. And the innermost layer is the core with radius of about 3500 kilometer. It is mainly made up of nickel and iron. So it is known as knife. So it is knife. So what did we say? Cl is in the continental crust. Cma is in the oceanic crust, and inner core is knife. Knife is in the inner core. Okay, so that is what is there. Next, coming to the rocks and minerals. So the earth's crust is made up of various types of rocks. Any natural mass of mineral matter that makes up the earth's crust is called the rock. So what is rock? Any natural mass of mineral matter that makes up the earth's crust is called rock. Rocks can be of different color, size and texture. So there are three major types of rocks. What are they? Igneous rock, sedimentary rock and metamorphic rocks. Igneous rocks are those which are formed by solidifying of magma, and sedimentary rocks are by the deposition of rocks in various layer, and metamorphic rocks are rocks which is by changing the shape of the two rocks that we have. So we have igneous rock, sedimentary rock and metamorphic rock. Now when the molten magma cools down, when the molten magma cools, it becomes solid. So we saw the lava is there and the molten magma will come out and they will cool down. So it will become solid. Now, if the solidification of this rock, so this kind of rocks are igneous rock. Now, the thing is, they are also called primary rocks, and there are two types of igneous rock. One is intrusive rocks and one is extrusive rocks. So we have intrusive rocks, we have extrusive rocks. And lava is actually fiery red molten magma which is coming out of the interior of the earth surface. So when this molten lava comes out of the earth and it cools down rapidly, it becomes solid. Now rocks formed in such a way, it is known as extrusive igneous rock. So if the magma comes out and here it gets solidified, it is known as extrusive igneous rock. They have very fine grain structure, for example basalt. So the Deccan Plateau is made up of basalt rocks. Sometimes the molten magma, they will cool down inside the earth's surface or inside the earth's crust. Okay, so the solid rocks so formed are called as intrusive igneous rocks. So if it solidifies outside, if the magma solidified outside, then it's known as extrusive igneous rock, and if it solidifies inside the earth's crust, it is known as intrusive igneous rock. Since they cool down slowly, they form large grains. Granite is an example of such rock. Grinding stones used to prepare paste, powder or spices and grains are made of granite. Now the rocks are there. We always studied by sand or by wind or by water, river. So rocks, they will keep on rolling. They will roll, they will crack, they will hit each other and they will break down into small fragments. And the smaller particles, they will start forming sediments. Okay. And these sediments are transported and deposited by wind, water, etc. These loose sediments are compressed and hardened to form layers of rock, and this is known as sedimentary rocks. For example, sandstone is made of grains of sand. These rocks may also contain fossils of plants, animals and other microorganisms that once lived on them. So because they are forming sediments, so I can have some organisms which would have died and then there was a deposition. So under pressure, they form the fossils. Okay. Now, igneous and sedimentary rocks can change into metamorphic rock under great heat and pressure. For example, clay changes into slate and limestone into marble. Rocks are very useful to us. The hard rocks are used for making roads, houses and buildings. So there are various uses of rocks. You use stones in many games. For example, seven stones like pitto, hopscotch, that is tapu or kit. Okay, then five stones, gitti. So there are many games that, you know, your grandparents or would have played by using stones. So you will be surprised to know that one type of rock changes into another under certain condition in a cyclic manner. So this transformation of rocks is taking place in a cyclic manner. So this process of transformation of rock from one to another is known as rock cycle. So that is rock cycle. So when the molten magma, so if the rock cycle is here, if you see, when the molten magma cools, it solidifies and it forms this igneous rock. So molten magma is forming the igneous rock. Okay. Now these igneous rock, they will be broken down into small particles and they are transported and deposited to form sedimentary rocks. Okay. When these igneous rocks and sedimentary rocks are subjected to heat and pressure, so they both can form metamorphic rock. Fine, under heat and pressure. the metamorphic rocks which are still under heat and pressure, they will again form this molten magma. Okay, this molten magma again will cool down and solidify and make igneous rocks. So there is a complete cycle of rocks that is happening. This is rock cycle, and rocks are made up of different minerals. Minerals are naturally occurring substances which have certain physical properties and definite chemical composition. Minerals are very important to humankind. Some are used as fuels. For example, coal, natural gas, and petroleum. They are also used in industries, iron, aluminium, gold, uranium, etc., in medicines, in fertilizers, etc. So this is all about the chapter in NCERT geography, and the chapter is inside our earth. So we complete it. Thank you.